In today's Modern Parent, we tackle a tough task, getting the kids to bed. If you need help putting the little ones to sleep, listen up to this advice from the Children's Workshop.
You know, our kids need adequate amounts of sleep so that the next day they can be successful. Whether or not they're going to school, they have other activities that they're going to do, we all need sleep.
Get a consistent amount of sleep every night.
I really think it's important to set aside at least a good 20 to 30 minutes prior to your child's sleep time, just so you can establish a routine. You know, they're going to know what's expected of them, there will be no surprises. And children thrive off of routines. It's just what they need, it's what they like. It makes them feel like they're in control. So setting some type of routine is so important for your kids.
Going from playtime to bedtime can be very difficult.
You have to be really careful with your words, and you have to use transitional words with your kids. One thing you can do is say, you know, first we're going to eat dinner, then we're going to take a bath, and then we're going to bed. Your kids understand, you know, what's coming first, next, and last.
Put technology away.
Your child's brain is a little too stimulated to actually rest when they're watching TV, and even for a short period of time after they're watching TV. So turn off all of your electronic devices, your cell phone as a parent, your tablets, and, you know, give your kids a good 30 minutes away from a screen even before you start your bedtime routine.
A calm routine can help.
I really think that taking a nice warm bath every night before bed really helps kids, you know, calm down and relax. Reading a story, obviously, kids love to be read to. But if you sit in a cozy area, maybe you sit right in your child's bed, maybe you have a cozy chair that you sit in every night, maybe you have a stuffed animal, where it's just the two of you, you might read one or two stories, and that really helps your child calm their body.
Maybe offer a light snack or drink.
Make sure that snack time is separate from bedtime, though. You don't want to be bringing drinks and snacks into the child's bed or their bedroom. Our brains need to know that there are places where we eat and then there are places that we sleep.
Saying goodnight can be tough.
I find with my son, if I save one book for last, it's just a goodnight book. So the book is telling him it's time to go to bed, and it's not mommy saying, you have to go to bed now, so I like to maybe put the book in control.
Never use bedtime as a threat or a punishment.
You never want to say to your kids, if you don't do such and such, I'm going to send you to your bed, because we want their bed to be a positive thing. Sleep is something that they need. It's a healthy habit.
Now, each week, the Children's Workshop brings us helpful parenting tips, so be sure to tune in or check them out or head to roadshow.com to see past segments.